Good morning. We're standing by to take you to Sydney for a COVID update from the New South Wales Premier Gladys Berejiklian. It follows a confusing weekend for residents in the southwest of Sydney. A lot of changes to the COVID rules there, with construction workers notably across the Greater Sydney area told that they cannot go to work for the foreseeable future, at least to the end of July. Construction sites right across the region have been closing down, some as late as this morning, getting ready to reopen, perhaps, as I say, in another fortnight's time. Also on the weekend, the number of jobs that were prescribed as not being able to leave the Fairfield LGA, they were also updated. But here now is the Premier.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you to the 76,000 people who came forward for testing to 8 p.m. last night. That is an outstanding response, especially on a weekend. Unfortunately, New South Wales still recorded 98 cases of community transmission. 20 of those were infectious in the community. And please remember, that 20 number is the number we're really keen to nudge. We need to get ahead of that number in order to reduce the cases in the community, and the closer we get that number to zero is a signal that we can end the lockdown. So can I stress that it's really, really important for people to get tested when they have the mildest of symptoms, or even if you don't have symptoms but you live in a particular area and you're leaving for work, please make sure you follow the testing guidelines. It's so important for that to occur. Unfortunately, more than two-thirds of those cases are still in southwestern Sydney. And can I please stress, and I know this has impacted many families, that sometimes you don't even need to have symptoms to give the virus to your loved ones. So please, you might think you're doing the right thing by visiting a relative or going into another household. Please don't. We're seeing so many cases of families going through distress because they're moving from household to household thinking they're doing the right thing. But unfortunately, even when you don't have symptoms, you might not know you're carrying the virus. And as the health experts say, this variant, this Delta strain of the virus, makes you more likely to be transmissible or to be contagious or to spread it. So I can't say that enough. Please know, stick to your household, don't move between households. And please make sure you keep those you love the most safest. We're just seeing so many examples of entire households getting the virus and in distress because that those that are closest to them are getting the virus because they've unintentionally or by mistake, unfortunately, spread the virus. And we really want to see that stop. And I don't want to see families and individuals go through the guilt and the distress and see loved ones impacted by what is, as Dr. Chant says every day, a very serious illness. So can I please get that message out as strongly as I can? I also know this week there will be special celebrations around Al-Adha, and I just ask families to please know, as hard as it is, I mean, I haven't seen my parents for a month, and I know that's very small compared to what a lot of families are going through. But I just ask everybody to please think about their loved ones. You might think you're doing the right thing, but we just need families to stay in their family home and not move from household to household because unfortunately too many people are getting sick from that. And the second highest example of transfer of the virus at this stage is in workplaces. That's why we've put those rules around workplaces in particular. That's why we've had to ask some businesses to down tools until July 30, because workplaces unfortunately not only spread the virus to colleagues, but potentially spread the virus to other communities because people from different areas are coming together at a workplace. And now some of these workplaces have been workplaces where people need to go to. And fortunately, we haven't seen a huge transfer to patrons, but definitely through work colleagues. So please, if we can just stress, be extra, extra careful in relation to workplaces and also in relation to your own family members who don't live in your household. These are two areas we really need to focus on. And I'm convinced if we work together, we will see that number go down. We won't see the effect of the harsher, even though we've been in hard lockdown, we won't see the effect of the harsher restrictions for another 4 or 5 days. But I know they're there to be had if all of us stick together and work hard. And I also wanted to stress today that if you've been impacted in the last 3 weeks or in the last few days by decisions the government has made in relation to your personal work situation or your business, please know the help is there. So please know, if you're an individual, go through Services Australia to get those disaster payments, those immediate payments that come to you. And please go to Service New South Wales. And we understand there have been tens of thousands of people already on the phones this morning. And we ask for your patience. But if you're a business, please go to Service New South Wales to get the assistance you need to get those grants coming through. We know this is a difficult time for so many. We know that. All of us are in this together, and I just ask everybody to stick with it and to be as patient as you can. But please know, no matter what you're going through, there is help for you. And no matter what you're going through, chances are there are other people in our community going through the same stresses. I know New South Wales is up for the task. I know we can beat this thing. But it does mean us listening to those messages provided every day and making sure all of us are doing the right thing. I'll now ask Dr. Chant to provide her update, then Deputy Commissioner Warboys, about the great work police are doing on the ground to support communities, and then we'll take your questions.
New South Wales recorded 98 locally cases of COVID in the 24 hours to 8 p.m. last night. As the Premier said, we still had 20 cases that were infectious in the community for over one day. It is important that we get that number down. But it is pleasing to see that the venues have been narrowed and that people appear to be taking the health advice about limiting the time spent anywhere and also not going out when you're sick. COVID is a severe illness, and I just want to highlight the fact that what the Premier has said, that COVID can be spread to others even if you don't have symptoms. So we're getting a lot of misunderstandings that if I'm well, how could I possibly infect someone else? And the reality is you don't know. You don't know that you have the disease. And actually, with this Delta variant, you're actually most likely to spread it to others even just before you've got, around that time when you've got symptoms, before you have no symptoms at all, you are most likely to spread it. And so again, please do not visit anyone. What we want you to do is stay within your households. In terms of the locally acquired cases, the majority still are in southwestern Sydney Local Health District. And can I extend my utmost gratitude to the community of southwestern Sydney who have come out for testing and are actually bearing the burden of this impact of COVID on them and their loved ones. And I just want to acknowledge the way that the community is responding. But unfortunately, it is the Delta variant, with its transmissibility, requires us almost to be perfect at all times. So don't go and visit anyone else. Don't have anyone into your home. Please be so safe when you're going outside. Wear a mask and make sure it covers your nose and nose and mouth when you're entering any indoor premises, queuing. Make your trips as short as possible. And remember that message about chemist shops, pharmacies. Don't go there if you've got symptoms. Instead, you should be actually going and getting a test. In terms of the cases by local government area, again, Fairfield local government area has 47, Canterbury, Bankstown 13, and Liverpool 13, reflecting the fact that the disease burden in those areas is significantly high. We are seeing a lot of the pattern that a lot of them are households. So once we find one case in a household, the remaining household members soon are almost positive at the time of detection or soon become positive. There are currently 82 COVID cases admitted to hospital with 24 in intensive care. And of the 24 people in intensive care, one has had a vaccination, with one person having had a dose of AstraZeneca vaccine. Again, vaccination is critical. Can I just urge everyone in the community who is eligible for the vaccine to go forth and make an appointment? Go on to the eligibility checker and access the vaccine. I would urge anyone in particularly over 60 to go and get an AstraZeneca vaccine from their general practice. And remember, I've also said that GPs are working very hard and they will prioritise older individuals over younger in terms of bookings because of the need to protect our elderly. But even one dose of the AstraZeneca can have some effect, as well as the one dose of the Pfizer. But two doses gives that optimal protection. And both having those two doses of the vaccine can really reduce your risk of hospitalisation and death associated with COVID. The areas of concern for increased testing are Lakemba, Punchbowl, Fairfield, Bankstown, Liverpool, Cumberland, Merrylands, Guildford, Wollongong, Blaney, Parkes, Coffs Harbour, Crow's Nest, St Leonards, Mittagong, Burradoo and St George's River, Bayside and Sutherland Shire. And this goes to my final point, that we do need to make sure that we aren't complacent, that this is just an issue in southwestern Sydney. It is far from. What we need to do is every time we leave our house, be vigilant in who we interact with. We've talked a lot about reducing mobility, but in essence, what we're talking about is reducing the opportunity of bringing people together, because that is ultimately how COVID is spread. Why we're concerned about workplaces is they are bring together people from different parts, geographical areas, and so have those characteristics of potentially introducing COVID, if we have a workplace transmission event, into other settings and other communities. So whilst there will be the need for some critical work to go on, we do need to support the functioning of society. It is incredibly important that as we go about our workplace functions, that we take this threat seriously and follow the health advice. Thank you.
Good morning. Thank you, Dr. Chan, Minister Premier. 201 infringement notices issued in the last 24 hours. Of note, 121 of those in regional New South Wales. That's north, west and south of the Greater Sydney area. What I want to emphasise today, that the strategy that police are working on is not a ring of steel. We are not operating on a ring of steel around Greater Sydney, not around any LGA, not around southwest Sydney. New South Wales Police Force has 17,700 employees, police officers that are competent, well-resourced, and every single day are provided taskings right across the state. When we look at the spread of those infringement notices, it shows that the concentration of police and their efforts around the pandemic is right across the state of New South Wales. New South Wales Police will continue to review those on a daily basis and move resources wherever is necessary. Thank you.
So New South Wales Health provided data that we needed to do more at reducing those mobility. And as I said, the key underpinning driver for that is the interactions between people. So what we indicated is that we needed to do more to reduce those opportunities for people to come together. We were also concerned that we had seen a number of outbreaks in workplaces which were further seeding other parts of Sydney. So that was the basis of the health advice, is we need to reduce workplace attendances, we need to reduce the opportunity for workplace transmission events to occur, and we need to ultimately stop opportunities for people to interact with other people.
Are you confident, Premier, are you confident that you will...
Can we get an update on testing? And the turnaround time for testing rates seems to be slipping a fair bit. What's your average turnaround time now? And are you prioritising southwest Sydney over other parts of Sydney?
So we've got a range of strategies in place, and we're working closely with the private system, which is doing a lot of the testing as well as complemented by the activities of the public. In terms of the turnaround times, we know some providers are taking some additional steps to improve their turnaround time, and we're working closely with those private providers. In general, the turnaround times are still holding up, but there is specific issues that are being addressed, and we just to reassure the community that if you are a close contact and if you've been told by public health to go and get a test, please make it known that that's the reason you're there. We have mechanisms with all of the private pathology and some specific services we are running to make sure that you get tested promptly. Because as you know, whilst we're doing a lot of surveillance testing, which has been very useful at identifying people without symptoms and potentially infectious in the community, we want to preserve the fact that our highest risk group are those that are in close contacts. And so just if you are in the line, in any of the queues, please draw the collector's attention to the fact that you are a close contact and have been directed by public health. There are processes by which that will be written on the form, and the private pathology companies have ability to to prioritise those specimens. I could actually say a request from the private pathologies is please do be patient. Unfortunately, when you are ringing up, it actually distracts some of their focus from logging the specimens and getting them swiftly through the machine. So I understand how it is a stressful time in someone waiting for a result, and people are quite anxious, but if people could be a little patient, that will help us get the turnaround times and maintain that high turnaround time.
Premier, are you confident that the measures you put in...
Crisis Cabinet is informed by the health advice. Could we just get a bit more clarity on how explicit that health advice is? So did you explicitly say to the government, I believe that construction sites are of such concern that we need to shut down the entire industry?
So in terms of the advice, we provide the advice in terms of the broad principles of what we need to see. We've highlighted the fact that I think there's that the disease burden is incredibly high in southwestern Sydney. And to some extent, we can define the problems of what we're trying to achieve from a public health objectives. And then it's a matter for how, whole of government puts input into it. I mean, clearly we're not the experts in logistic chains and other things. And so we need that whole of government approach to determine what things are critical, what things are not. And our objectives of decreasing workplace attendances, decreasing the opportunity for interactions is what we need to achieve. The matter for how that is done is really a matter for broader government. As you'd expect, we are not the experts on some of those factors.
Premier, are you confident that the measures you put in place on Saturday will do the trip, will do enough to get us out of lockdown over the next month or so? And did you consider at any point going the Victorian route on construction and, say, allowing 25% on site rather than the whole thing shut down?
Well, what's important for us is to respond to the critical health advice we received. And the critical health advice we received was the absolute risk of workplace transmission and the fact that thousands and thousands of people were moving around the community throughout Greater Metropolitan Sydney and sometimes even outside Greater Metropolitan Sydney on work which wasn't urgent or had to happen in the next fortnight. And what is really critical for the New South Wales government and for our citizens to know is we're throwing everything at this to make sure we get out of this lockdown as soon as we can. And having the risk of thousands and thousands of people being mobile at the one time, many of them coming from communities who've had cases, was too big a risk. And I appreciate how difficult the decision was. I think I expressed very frankly yesterday that it was the most difficult day in the office when we made that decision. But we have to. If we're serious about allowing individuals, families and businesses to bounce back as soon as we can, we must take these difficult decisions, which we did. And I also want to assure the community that we are working with the construction sector on safe ways to go back to business on July 31. And I want to make that very clear. The Treasurer, the Deputy Premier, key senior public servants are meeting with the construction sector daily to make sure that when they go back to work, there are safe workplaces in place for large businesses, medium-sized businesses and smaller businesses. What we can't have is people, especially who may not even have symptoms, visiting multiple work sites, visiting construction sites with hundreds of workers and spreading the disease. And that is a threat that was too great and given the health advice specifically related to reducing mobility, reducing workplace interaction, reducing household contacts, that is really key. And can I just make one point about households, which I should have stressed? Please make sure that you don't leave your household for those important celebrations that might be going on within your community. You have to stay within your household. Unfortunately, those closest to you, the ones you love the most, are at threat. So I just really urge everybody, in addition to making sure that we follow the health orders, especially in relation to work arrangements and also other matters, that we don't move from household to household.